Piercing Congregation was founded by St. Anne de Maruch in 1535. I think she founded it to develop young girls' talents and to make sure they get to their full potential. When St. Anne de Maruch founded the Ursuline Sisters, she wanted women to reach their full potential and expand their talents. And today at school, we're still encouraged to do this with ethos. I think she'd be very pleased with what she saw because women are still today like, encouraged every single day in class and school to reach their full potential and become the best girl they can be. I think what's different in the school community today is that the nuns obviously don't teach her anymore, but they're still highly involved with special occasions and school masses. And also the school is much more open to kind of like multicultural people, and you get to learn like much more about other countries and other religions and kind of what other people's stories are like. The thing about the guiding lesson for me today is be kind and approachable to those in your care. I think this really kind of speaks to everyone who goes to St. Andrews, because we are the people who care about us, therefore we must be kind and approachable to, and it's the same in the school community as there's many staff and students involved, and everyone looks after each other and everyone cares about each other, and we all must be approachable. So St. Andrews was known as the woman who refused the Pope because she refused Pope Clement's request to stay in Rome for her education. In 1535 she left Rome and she started the Ursuline Sisters, which encouraged young women to further their education. They were the first female congregation who encouraged young people to do this. So St. Angela lost both her sister and her parents at a young age, but I think everyone like today has lost someone, and I think it's really nice to hear the books to St. Angela these times. A second struggle she faced is she became blind at this time also, but this certainly didn't put a halt to